Hi, I'm Jonathan Klee, the Director of Missional Outreach here at Vox, and I have quite the unique service for you here this morning. As we're only online, there's also no one else here in the entire church with me. Many of our band members and staff and their family and other volunteers and our church members are homesick today, and so I am just here by myself, but I have quite the great service for you planned. I'm editing in past week's music, so you will still see the band up here. Don't worry, I'm not attempting to play any music. We just really wanted to still connect with you all today. I had already planned on preaching today, so I have a sermon ready. I have something special for the kids, and so we love you all. We're so glad that you could join us. We're praying for you as you're sick. Please let us know if you need anything. I'm going to open us up with a reading of Scripture, Hebrews 13, 1 through 3, and verse 5. Let mutual love continue. Do not neglect to show hospitality to strangers, for by doing that, some have entertained angels without knowing it. Remember those who are in prison as though you were in prison with them. Be content with what you have, and remember that God has promised, I will never leave you or forsake you. Amen.
Feet are on the rock. together as His children, to grasp how wide and long, how high and deep His love for us, and to know this love surpasses our knowledge, that we may be filled to the measure of all the fullness of God. And to Him who is able to do immeasurably more than we could ask, according to His great power that is at work within us. To Him be the glory in the church throughout all the generations, forever and ever. Amen. May we have power together His children, to grasp how wide and long, how high and deep His love for us, and to know this love that surpasses our knowledge, to the measure of all the fullness of God, that we may be filled to the measure of all the fullness of God. And to Him who is able to do immeasurably more than we could ask, according to His great power that is at work within us. And to Him be the glory in the church throughout all the generations, forever and ever. Amen. We want all that You are, every detail and part, to the measure of all the fullness of God, and then we overflow, 'cause our depths could never hold all the wonder and awe in the glory of it all. For You're all that we than we could ask. According to His great power that is at work within us. And to Him be the glory in the church throughout all the generations.
Amen. All right, good morning, everyone. Welcome. Thank you for joining me for this unique service, kind of the Klee takeover. Over the last few weeks, we've been in this little recurring topic about change and what do we want for our lives in the new year. We had an open mic Sunday reflecting on how we've grown this past year and what we look forward to in this new year. Last week, Rustin encouraged us to get connected at Vox and what it takes to live a transformed life in Jesus. So this week, I'm going to continue on this theme and talk a bit more about change and transformation. It's also that time of year where we have New Year's resolutions, and I've always kind of thought New Year's resolutions are cheesy, and recently I saw this old comic, and so I'm going to throw that up on the screen there. It says, "What exactly is a New Year's resolution?" The big dog says to the little dog, "It's a to-do list for the first week of January," says the little dog. And I think that kind of sums it up. Maybe that's why I don't like New Year's resolutions, because they don't really work. It reminds me of a funny episode of The Office where Michael Scott wanted to floss for his New Year's resolution, and he flossed one time and he was done for the year. 1st of January, got it out of the way. All right, so how are we to be transformed to become like Jesus? Because for most of us in our walk with Jesus, there's a gap between who we are now in the present and who we want and desire to grow and mature into in the future. And changing, transforming, is about closing that space, that gap. The reality to be human, we are all being formed. Every second of every minute of every day, we are being formed into somebody or something. One, by our stories that we believe, what we believe, by our habits, good or bad, and in between, and especially by our relationships. Some people think that transformation is self-driven. Do this, do that, do this more, do that better, more, 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 better, better, better. And that's not how it works. There's a tension here that we have to live into, a responsibility between both us and God. God also has a responsibility here. It's kind of a partnership, but I know it's not a 50-50 partnership. I don't know the mathematics, the calculations here, but we can all admit it's not a 50-50 partnership. But it does take both us and God to be transformed. For me, I've been thinking about this change and transformation lately because in business and in ministry and just building something tangible, change comes easy for me. I can look at numbers and know how to pivot and what's coming next. I can quickly come up with a 5-step plan for how a ministry or business should change to have a great impact on those they serve, and it'll work. But personally, change is hard, and it seems to be getting harder. I believe that often we don't know where to start or how to start. We get stuck because we focus too much on, like I said earlier, the more, 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 the better, better, better. Additionally, though, when it comes to something particular that we want to change or work on, this is actually a Bill Gates quote here. It says, we overestimate what we can accomplish in a year, but we underestimate what we can accomplish in 10. And I think that also breaks down to a micro level,
to say it this way, we overestimate what we can accomplish in a month, but we overestimate what we can accomplish in a year. This can be deflating to us. This can be why we get stuck. This is why we need more than ourselves, why we need to work on expanding that partnership with God. God actually wants you to grow and mature and to take on more and more responsibility in that partnership, in that joint effort to become your real true self. But that said, God is the real thing, not us. God does all the heavy lifting here. He's the focal point. To borrow words from Rustin from last week, God brings meaning. He's involved in our belonging, and he's the reason we can transform. And the end goal is that we become God's. God becomes the air we breathe, that we live and move and have our being in God. And this is transformation. The best scripture that I could find for this is 2 Corinthians 3:16-18. And I really love the Message version. All right, so here it is, 2 Corinthians 3:16-18 from the Message. Whenever, though, they turn to face God, as Moses did, God removes the veil, and there they are face to face. They suddenly recognize that God is a living, personal presence, not a piece of chiseled stone. And when God is personally present, a living spirit, that old, constricting legislation is recognized as obsolete. We are free of it. All of us, nothing between us and God, our faces shining with the brightness of his face, and so we are transformed, much like the Messiah. Our lives gradually become brighter and more beautiful as God enters our lives and we become like him. Amen. Guys, it's harder than we want. And it takes longer than we expect. There's no killer app. Willpower will not get you there. The freedom it talks about isn't the same as American freedom. It's not the ability to do whatever we want. It's more like the freedom to want the right thing because you got past your broken self. The imagery here, the imagery of transformation, is that of a caterpillar changing into a beautiful butterfly. Listen to that one more time. It's verse 18, the second half. We're free of it, all of us. Nothing between us and God. Our faces shining with the brightness of his face, and so we are transformed much like the Messiah, our lives gradually becoming brighter and more beautiful as God enters our lives and we become like him. Butterfly. That is transformation. It's complete, radical overhaul of our whole self from the inside out, but it's not just self-help or life enhancement. No app, no pill. There are things, there are key things that we can do in this partnership with God to be transformed, but we're not transformed just because we do more and better things. A ministry partner of mine who's planting a church was just talking about fellowship, and he said this: don't mistake proximity for fellowship. We're all in a different place, I know, and some of us need to take baby steps, and sometimes just being in the proximity of people is everything you can give, but in order to be transformed, our mindset, our why really matters. But seriously, all the grace, though, I know sometimes you gotta just fake it in order to show up and fake it in order to even move somewhere. But that's what it takes, is practice. That's what that faking, I say, is. The normal process of transformation is slow, but sometimes There's just a set free moment where you take a leap. You will never be transformed. You will never reach your full potential unless you frame your life around discipline, and in particular in the practices of Jesus, because that is how we get access to the power that is beyond us. I love this Dallas Willard quote. It says the disciplines are activities of mind and body purposely undertaken to bring our personality and total being into effective cooperation with the divine. I'll read that one more time since I screwed that up a little bit. Dallas Willard, the disciplines are activities of mind and body purposefully undertaken to bring our personality and total being into effective cooperation with the divine. Last week, Rustin said, we find our meaning when we commit, we find belonging when we take responsibility, and we're transformed through practice. All of these, commit, responsibility, and practice, enable us more and more to live in the power that is strictly beyond us. They are how we open ourselves up to God, and that's our part of this partnership with God. There's a gap. There's space between who you are and who Jesus is. We're frustrated by it. We're impatient by it and with it. We're tired of it. Some of us don't like the season of life we're in. But keep up. Follow Jesus. Devote your life to being with Jesus. Become like Jesus and do what he did. In time, you will change. You can change. You will be transformed. Let's close again by praying 2 Corinthians 3:18. We're free of it, all of us. Nothing between us and God, our faces shining with the brightness of his face. And so we are transformed, much like the Messiah, our lives gradually becoming brighter and more beautiful as God enters our lives and we become like him. Amen.
Hey kids, Frosty here leading the Vox prayers. Make sure you guys get outside and play in the snow. I love snow, it's wonderful. I'm gonna lead you guys all in some quick prayers, but I have to be quick because I can't be inside very long. I don't want to melt. So make sure you get outside, play in the snow today, go sledding with your mom and dad, throw snowballs at your brothers and sisters and friends. Let's be still and read this prayer of the first snow. I know I missed the real first snow, but I couldn't be here that Sunday. So here's the first snow. O Christ, King of snow, we bless you for bidding this blanket of white to cover us in this holy hush, that our hearts might be quieted at the sight, that we might sense the emptiness of canvas over which your spirit broods and upon which you would create and recreate our hearts in the image of the one whose word first spoke snow into existence. He gives snow like wool. He scatters frost like ash. Psalm 147:16. Amen. Oh my gosh, I am so sorry that Frosty came in here like that. I had no idea he was going to show up. It won't happen. I was going to say I won't let it happen again, but it won't, because he melted into a puddle before he made it out of the sanctuary. Got some cleanup to do in here. But anyways, I'm going to do just a quick few announcements. Hey, we are going to play this situation with COVID just week by week. We want to stay healthy and protect you all, and really just so many of our own Vox members who we love dearly are sick. And so we're just going to call it each week as it comes near Sunday and we see numbers going up or down. And so please let us know if you need anything and how we can be praying for you. But as soon as we are back in service, and hopefully even next Sunday, we will just hop right into the groups that we're supposed to start today with Jack Ramos leading the men's group. That'll be upstairs in one of the classrooms, and it's a men's discipleship group just to learn about reading the Bible. And he told me that this study is for men that just would rather not read, that would rather not read the Bible. So it's a great opportunity to learn more about God. And then there's also the women's group. Both these groups are Sunday mornings at 8:30. The women's group is with Kim Tribolet, and they're reading a book called Breathe, and they're going to be doing some breathing exercises and just learning how to rest and be in the Lord. And so, like I said, both those groups will start back up as soon as we decide it is healthy and safe for us to all be back in the building, and we'll keep you posted on that. Lastly, we are collecting warm weather goods for the homeless community in our neighborhood around the church. So if you want to bring hand warmers, scarves, gloves, hats, sweatpants, sleeping bags, anything that helps keep people warm, we're going to be putting them in the blessing box just right out here in our parking lot for those in need to grab. And we're also going to be giving them to Heart and Hand for them to give to the clients they serve in our community. So thank you all. I'm glad you're all watching today and enjoying this unique service.
As we move into communion, this is the time of the service that we bring an offering. If you want to make a financial offering as part of your act of worship, you can do so during this time by dropping it in the wooden box in the back of the room, or you can give online. Just go to vox.church and follow the links for giving. There are a variety of ways that you can contribute to what God is doing through Vox during this season financially. Let's pray for the resources that we offer as part of our worship. God, we offer finances, resources, things that we have sweat and labored to earn as part of our act of worship to you, as a remembrance that even that which we earn is a gift to have healthy bodies, a gift to have employment, a gift to have a way to make a way for ourselves and our family. And so we set aside this offering and bring it to you as part of our act of worship so that we can remember that all we have, even our very breath, is given. We thank you and we come in gratitude. We ask you to bless what it is that we bring, to increase your work here among us, that you would make the church faithful and well-resourced for what it is that you call us to do. We ask this in Jesus' name, amen. And now, let us hear again the story of the institution of the Holy Supper of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that Jesus was handed over to suffering and death, he gathered friends to a table. When he'd given thanks, he broke bread and gave it to them, saying, "This is my body broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And then after that meal, in the same way, he took the cup and he gave thanks and he said, "This is my blood, the new covenant, my blood shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this to remember me." Our Savior invites those who trust him to share the feast that he has prepared. This meal tells the story of all of reality, that Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again. So I invite you now to send somebody forward, if you're here with us, to send somebody forward from your pod to get a cup and a bowl. You can return to your pod and serve one another, knowing that this is the body of Christ broken for you and the blood of Christ, the cup of salvation. Amen.
I waited for the Lord, and at last he looked. He bent down and pulled me out, oh, of the deep, deep mud. And he stood me up on solid ground, made this weak heart strong. He gave me a song to sing, oh, it's rising now, oh, it's rising now. I've got this new song in my mouth. Can you hear it now? It's pouring. It's pouring out of my new life. I am found. Can you hear it now? It's pouring. It's pouring out. He taught me how to sing this rescue song. For everyone is lost and lonely. It's rising now. Whoa, it's rising now. I've got this new song in my mouth. Can you hear it now? It's pouring. It's pouring out of my new life. I am found in you. Here and now it's pouring. It's pouring out. I've got this new song in my mouth. Can you? Here and now it's pouring. It's pouring out of my new life. I am found in you. Here and now it's pouring. It's pouring out. And it goes on. Goes on. Oh, 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 oh. And it goes on. Oh, oh, oh. And it goes on. In my mouth, can you hear it now? It's pouring. It's pouring out of our new life. We are found. Can you hear it now? It's pouring. It's pouring out. We got this new song in our mouths. Can you hear it now? It's pouring. It's pouring out of our new life. We are found in you. Here and now it's pouring. It's pouring out. It goes on. Oh, 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 oh.
All right, I will send you out today with a blessing. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance on you and give you his peace now and forever. Amen.